An inclined plane is used to lift loads from the ground. Now, as you realize, it is more convenient to lift loads using an inclined plane, because with inclined planes, you lift loads more easily as compared to lifting them vertically from the ground. So you have a choice. If you're having a load such as this, you can, if it is at this point, you can either lift it directly up, or you can use an inclined plane to roll it along an inclined plane to the height where you want it. Of course, it is more convenient for you to roll it along the inclined plane to the height where you want it, versus lifting this load from here vertically upwards. This is why we use inclined planes. Now, with inclined planes, an effort is going to be applied through this distance L, and this length is definitely equivalent to the length of the inclined plane. So with this, the velocity ratio here definitely is going to be the effort distance over the load distance. Now, of course, the load, when you're lifting it from here to bring it to this point, you have taken it from the ground level through a certain distance up to there. So it means that as far as velocity ratio is concerned, the distance moved by the load, this load, you have moved it from this point up to that point. So the load distance is H. But then the effort distance, the effort that moved this thing from up to here had to go through that length, that distance, which is equivalent to L, the length of the inclined plane. So it means that velocity ratio of this load is going to be the ratio of the effort distance, which is L, divided by the load distance, which is H. A trolley of weight 10 newtons is pulled from the bottom to the top of an inclined plane by a force of 2 newtons. If the height is H and the length is 20 meters, what is the mechanical advantage, velocity ratio, and its efficiency? Now, we'll draw a simple sketch to illustrate this question. The trolley is having a weight of 10 newtons, and it is pulled from the bottom to the top of an inclined plane by a force of 2 newtons. So it's being pulled by a force of 2 newtons. Now, if the height is 2 meters, so the height here is 2 meters, and the length here is, the length is 20 meters, the length along the inclined plane. What is the mechanical advantage? So mechanical advantage is going to be equal to load over effort, and that's definitely going to be equal to, now the load, like according to the question, is 10. So it's 10, divide that by the effort, which is 2 newtons. So it means that the mechanical advantage, therefore, is 5. Then the velocity ratio. The velocity ratio is going to be equal to the distance moved by effort. So the effort distance divided by the load distance. And that is going to be, now the effort distance is 20 meters through this, along this inclined plane. Divide that by the load distance. Now the load distance is 2 meters. And of course the velocity ratio will be 10. A ratio. Now, the efficiency. To find the efficiency, is going to be equal to mechanical advantage over velocity ratio times 100%. Now, the mechanical advantage we got is 5. Divide that by the velocity ratio, which is 10, times 100%. And you find that the mechanical advantage there is 50%. The efficiency is 50%. That's a number for you to try out. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for tuning in. For more of this video, simply subscribe. And please remember to share this video. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Ranga Kuramia.